What it do, everybody? Welcome back to Who's Your Best Friend, the show where we see whether or not pop culture icons and characters will make good friends or not. So without wasting time, let's make some friends. Today we're going to be looking at Aang, aka the Last Airbender, aka the Boy in the Iceberg, aka the second best avatar to ever have their own TV show. Before we get going, I have to let you all know that this will obviously contain spoilers pertaining to the show, so if you haven't seen the show, finish watching this video, go watch the show, and they get angry that I spoiled it for you. No, I've never been a fan of camping. It doesn't make sense to me. Why sleep outside when you can sleep inside? Why sleep in a sleeping bag when you can sleep in a bed? Why stab yourself in the coochie when you can just rub one out? I think you get the idea. Camping sounds stupid, and these niggas have been camping since day one on some globe-trotting shit. Nah. That ain't my lifestyle. Oh, but Gami, they're not guapped out like you. They don't have first world problems like you. They don't have the money to sleep in an inn every night. Just build a portable home. You have Miss No Eyes over here who has the ability to split a mountain in two if she ever got the opportunity. Like, just have some blueprints on deck. Y'all could be booling in a luxury 4-bedroom condo at any point in time. Or maybe you can fuck around and make 6 bedrooms. Why not? You have an earthbender there. But nah, let's just sleep on the dirt. Pink slip sitting in the dashboard with me. Got a gang of bros riding in their own drugs with me. Now this is a nice segue into the next aspect, and this is traveling. These niggas travel too much. I don't like traveling. I know. I'm not a very interesting person. My hobbies include screaming into a camera, drawing titties, and crying myself to sleep every single night. You can't really do that when you're on the move 24/7. Plus the commute is fucking awful.
Welcome to Air Upper, where there's no in-flight snacks, no onboard entertainment, no seatbelts, and no chance of survival if this flying bison gets shot down, because the only person capable of flight is a 12-year-old boy and a stick. No thank you.
Like, even though all that other shit sucks, it would be kinda cool to be rolling around with the avatar. That's like rolling around with a person who's able to play the guitar with their feet while driving 120 kilometers on the highway on a unicycle. You just don't see that shit every day. Now just imagine all the crazy shit you'd see on a daily basis. You got niggas boxing with fire. You got niggas squabbing with water. You got niggas throwing bricks and shit. Trust me, y'all ain't ever gonna see a man firebend with his dome, bro. Like, that shit's crazy. Homeboy, like, you just be chilling. Homeboy just start blasting niggas. And you're like, oh, oh, oh. Shit, like, things would just be blowing up and shit. Be like, y'all niggas see that shit? That shit was crazy, bruh. Whole time I was ready, they was like, hold up, wait a minute. I was like, nah, nigga, let's get it. Ooh, we about to get controversial again. Personally, I love insensitive jokes. I think they can be executed very well if you keep a few things in mind. One, knowing your audience. Two, the delivery. And three, the context of the joke. All these things are important because, say for instance, what if you get into a flame session with the squad? I'm talking Aang, Katara, Zuko, and Toph. Like, your homies, like, it's bound to happen. There is so much ammunition when it comes to these guys. Like, it would generally be unfair. I wish a nigga would say some shit about me if I'm in this squad.
Yeah, that's why there ain't no niggas in this world. Well, 3,000 subscribers, we're trying to get 10% to watch your videos. Head ass boy.
And me, being an intellectual, I have to appropriately respond by saying, boy, and I'm at to flame you like Sozin did your entire race. Oh, 112-year-old fucking with a 14-year-old girl, head ass boy. Like, it'd just be unfair. Like, all these niggas can catch smoke if they wanted to. Like, the boy Sokka, where you're bending at, boy? The girl Katara, ain't nobody trying to hear what you have to say, head ass boy. Oh, Zuko, I got some Vaseline for your face, head ass boy. Tough. She ain't even gonna see it coming. Obviously, if you've just met someone and you're trying to be their friend, don't be a dickhead and try to flame them in like the first opportunity you get. I give it 3 to 5 months, but personally, I can't be friends with someone for a long period of time if they can't catch the schmuck. That's what friendship is based upon, bringing each other down to a level where everyone feels like shit. Everyone knows this. Niggas is bitter, they hurting. Look at the business mergers. Throw back when I'm swerving. Big body, my Suburban. In conclusion, I'm sure there are other reasons why Aang would make a good friend, but for the life of me, I just can't see them. Maybe they disappeared with the rest of his race. Who knows? Would I personally be his friend? I guess if I could stay home and just have the ability to text a nigga while he out doing his thing, then yeah, sure. But Wi-Fi ain't even exist in that world, so shit. That's way too much effort, yeah, so I'm gonna have to pass on that one. But like I said, that's just me. Would you be his friend? Let me know down below and in the poll above. But until next time, you know what's up, never grow up, and I will check you.